Sibling from That's So Raven, and you're watching Disney Channel.
So it comes to pass that Dave the Barbarian does approach the wisest in all the kingdom with a grave and ponderous question.
What rhymes with cannoli?
If I'm so wise, how come I'm working for a bonehead like you?
Come on, help me out. I'm trying to finish my new musical, Oh Pastry. It's the touching story of one man's love for baked goods.
There are words to describe how stupid that is, but if I said them, I'd get bleeped.
Please, Uncle Oswidge, don't make me sign any more papers.
But a prince's hat?
I don't want to be some dumb ruler who makes dumb laws. I just want to hang out with my dumb friends.
Candy, Mom and Dad said you have to rule Udragoth. I know it's hard, but it's your responsibility.
Easy for you to say. They didn't leave you with this dumb job.
No, but if they had, I would bear the burden with grace, dignity, and style. Also, I'd redo the throne room in a Polynesian motif.
Fine!
Ha! Hat hair!
You'll be ruler for a few days. I'm gonna go hang out with my friends.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Bad time for a vacation. I hear Chuckles the Silly Piggy is planning to invade.
It's just a rumor.
Not really. He sent the letter. Dear Kingdom of Udragoth, I will be invading soon. Love, the Dark Lord Chuckles the Silly Piggy. P.S. I hope you enjoy the fruitcake.
He sent a fruitcake? The fiend!
Well, it's King Dave's problem now.
I'm the king!
Not quite. It ain't official until you sit on the enchanted throne. Now it's gonna keep doing that all day!
Ooh, comfy.
State your name!
Dave!
All hail the mighty ruler!
Dave!
His word is law!
Please keep your hands and feet inside the throne room at all times.
Now you're the king. At least until somebody else sits on the throne.
So now I can make laws. I'll make the best laws ever, and everyone will love me. Yes, love me.
King Dave hereby proclaims, effective immediately, the establishment of Casual Dress Friday.
Oh, wow, that is so much better.
Next Friday, I'm going to wear sneakers.
You see? They love me! This is great!
Yeah, I thought I'd never get a chance to wear this shirt.
That law is gonna be hard to top. What next? What next? Oh, I know! Henceforth, every Saturday will be Udragoth Spirit Day. All subjects will wear the kingdom's official colors. Red, a slightly darker red, and another red, a lot like the first one, but more sort of salmon-y. Did you get all that?
Henceforth...
I'll do it myself.
And another red a lot like the first one, but more sort of salmon-y. So proclaims King Dave.
Yeah, okay.
Happy Udragoth Spirit Day. Hey, do you think all this red makes me too easy a target for attackers?
A little.
Udragoth. Yahoo. Yahoo.
Brother's stupid Spirit Day law. Red is so not my color. It makes me look slain.
I don't care what stupid laws he makes as long as he's the one making them. Hey, are you gonna eat your entrails?
This is great! I can do anything I want and make everybody happy! Anything! Now, what other brilliant laws can I pass? Aha! You know what's always bugged me? I'm allergic to cat fur, and I bet a lot of other people are too, huh?
So, what can you do about that?
And therefore, all subjects must immediately shave their cats! So proclaims King Dave!
He was going okay until I started shaving his belly.
Yeah, they look pretty cute till they get mad, huh?
Make it quick. I'm working on my musical.
You gotta stop passing all these stupid laws. Everybody's really mad at you. Especially the cats.
It says meow.
And they mean it.
But I wanted them to love me. Now they've turned against their great and wonderful king. I'll show them. Heads will roll. Excruciating punishments will be enacted. Wedgies will be given. No. A good king battles an unruly populace with acts of kindness. I'll win them over by providing a little culture. I'll make a law requiring everyone in Udragoth to attend the opening of my new musical, Oh, Pastry!
I think most people would rather have the excruciating punishments.
Silence!
Oh, the king wrote a musical!
That's gotta be a complete
work of genius.
Every subject must attend, but if we go, the kingdom will be unguarded against invaders.
Nope. See, it says all invaders must attend as well.
Wow, the king thinks of everything.
But meanwhile, outside Udragoth, the Dark Lord chuckles, the silly piggy sees his chance.
It's show time! Oh!
With all the suffering in the world that makes us feel sad or irate, one thing still fills us all with joy and starchy carbohydrates.
Pastry, why the heck are you so tasty? With sugariness you grazed me. Oh, pastry, you're sweet and gooey, soft and chewy. You're so great, you drive me screwy. Pastry, pastry, pastry!
Anybody home? I brought another fruitcake!
Are you kidding me with that?
No, you stupid chair! Now make me king, or I'll reupholster you in a really ugly plaid!
All hail the mighty ruler!
The Dark Lord chuckles the silly piggy!
His or her word is law!
What, his or her? What, you can't tell?
Alas, poor Danish! What is thy filling? Well, who knows better than the Danish prince? You're filled with...
cheese and sugar, cheese and sugar, with the texture of a burger.
I, the Dark Lord Chuckles, the silly piggy, am seated upon the throne of Udragoth. I am your king now. And my first law is no musical theater.
We have to stop him.
Yeah.
So far, I like the pig's laws better than Dave's.
Fools! You cannot defeat me! I am all powerful! You can stop me!
As the true king of Udragoth, I order you to stop being mean! Jobbers! Actually, Chuckles, it seems like you're doing a pretty good job.
Dave!
With the combined power of the throne and the mystic amulet of Hawk's Swineboard, I am invincible!
Behold!
Okay, time for new laws. First, pickled pig's feet do not belong in jars in delis. They belong on pigs' ankles!
You call that a law?
It beats shaving cats!
Oh, man. Even the bad guy's laws aren't as bad as mine. I wanted to make all my subjects happy and... Instead, they all hate me.
Oh, don't beat yourself up, Dave.
Thanks, Fang.
Let me do it! All right, Pig Boy, I'm here to put an end to your badness!
Ooh, one little girl! I'm so scared!
Not just one little girl. All of Ultragon!
We will defend to the death he who brought us casual dress Friday.
Even if he did make us watch that awful play!
You know, you don't have to yell like that when you're not making proclamations.
Yell like what? They do love me!
Yay! Ultragothians! Charge!
So, did you like the fruitcake?
So, Piggy, any last words before we banish you?
I'd just like to say that...
Loyal subjects, I want to thank you for standing by me even though I went a little wacky with the laws there. And since my musical was interrupted, I'd like to perform the closing number for you.
Pastry, pastry.
That seemed a little harsh.
Wow, that was sure lucky.
Ow.
We'll be back with more of Dave the Barbarian.
Next Friday, be sure to catch the world television premiere of Hannah Montana's music video, Best of Both Worlds. Check it out and rock it out next Friday at 7:55, 6:55 Central on Disney Channel.
My brother and I have starred in all the school's productions, and we really welcome newcomers. There are a lot of supporting roles in the show. I'm sure we can find something for you.
It's hard to believe that I couldn't see.
You were always there beside me. Thought I was alone, with no one to hold. But you were always right beside me.
This feeling's like no other.
I want you to know, I never had someone that knows me like you do. The way you do. I never had someone as good for me as you. No one like you. So lonely before
it's so good to be seen, so good to be heard.
Don't have to say a word.
For so long I was lost, so good to be found. I'm loving having you around. This feeling's like no other. I want you to know.
For me as you, no one like you. So lonely before I finally found what I've been looking for.
Zach and Cody want a pet.
How about a tarantula?
No.
A turtle?
No.
An iguana?
No.
So they settle on a horse.
Holy cedar skin!
The Sweet Life of Zach and Cody. New episode next Friday at 6:35 Central on Disney Channel.
The Emperor's New School, a show about many things, such as philosophy.
A smile is a frown turned upside down.
Family.
Nuh-uh.
Uh-huh.
Nuh-uh.
Uh-huh.
Nuh-uh.
Love.
Melina.
Oh.
And other things, too, like pure evil. Trickery. Sneakery. Whacked out squirrels. Sad rabbits. Bad experiments. Dancing cats. High fashion. And much, much more.
Exactly.
The Emperor's New School. Fridays at 5, 4 Central on Disney Channel.
And now, back to Dave the Barbarian.
History. There have been many great barbarian heroes. Kronkaz, the Smasher. Morton, the Ridiculer. Hey, Pizza Face. Shebor, the Stomper on Things until they're squished into mushy paste.
Are you paste yet?
Not quite.
These mighty heroes have been honored in the most ancient and venerable of all art forms.
One pack of famous barbarian trading cards, please, or I'll crush you like a grape!
That'll be 3 Dracles.
Then I'll give you a Dracle off for not crushing me.
Thanks, Mrs. Bombmelon. Kronkaz the Smasher, junk. Mortad the Ridiculer, junk. Shebor the blah blah blah, junk. Strom the Slayer, yes! Now, I've got Strom's trading card, an action figure, and poster, and lunchbox, his board game, complete table setting, and snow globe, his official biography, his unofficial biography, his officially unofficial biography, and his new and improved super deluxe monkey warmer.
Is it hot in here, or is it me?
Hands off the monkey warmer, man!
But I want to touch the monkey!
Hey, now you can get Strom's autograph, too.
What?
He's coming to town today.
Yeah, right. Like I wouldn't have heard about it.
It, Mona. There's no point in running, you better not flee. You got less of a chance than a fish in a tree. Get back, Strom the Slayer's here. Look out, Strom the Slayer!
Hey, I bet he'd sign that trading card if you get down there. Soon.
Ah, here to slay the dragon. How are you? Ah, here to slay the dragon. How are you? Ah, here to slay the dragon. How you doing?
Thus, Fang at last has the opportunity to meet the hero who has inspired her over the years. An opportunity she completely and utterly...
Ah, here to slay the dragon.
Blues.
Ah, here to slay the dragon. How?
Strom. Nobody here's heard of a dragon.
What? I'm here to slay the dragon, people! You know, big scaly monster? Fangs? Wings? Been terrorizing you for years?
Do we have one of those?
We got a giant troll. Why don't you slay him?
Excuse me. Oh, can I get past? Pardon me. Sorry, my bad. This is the Slay the Dragon Tour. Not doing trolls this year. Maybe next year. The point is, I need a dragon to slay.
Doesn't Dave have a pet dragon?
Is it a gigantic vicious beast?
Hey, it's more of a dumb little fine potato or something.
Close enough. I shall slay it by the setting sun. Now, who wants a t-shirt? They're absolutely free. Plus a small service charge of 50 Dracles.
Oh, yeah! Can I get two?
I don't believe it.
That Strom wants to slay Faffy?
That he can give away t-shirts for free. It's not cost-effective.
The thing is, Faffy, this Strom guy is huge and mighty and stuff, and he wants to, you know, slay you. Ooh. But don't panic. We're gonna help. Right, Fang?
And so, our heroes set out to save Faffy. Dave's plan is to teach Faffy the art of disguise.
You're gonna have to give up this breathing nonsense.
Candy's plan is to teach him the ancient martial art of Taekwondo.
It's not as good for fighting as Taekwondo, but it's great for firming the buttocks. Begin.
Oswich's plan is to use magic. Sadly, it is his magic.
So Strom wants a big dragon, huh? I'll give him a big dragon. A wood dragon! Blood, pierce him in! Flockin' kickin'!
I did not need to see that.
Even Fang tries to help protect the poor dragon from her famous barbarian hero.
Strom the Slayer has slain griffins and basilisks and manticores. He's slain so much stuff it's amazing anything's still alive. He is exactly what I want to be when I grow up. And I am not going to have my hero come to my house and see what a wimp my dragon is. So hide!
Fang's suggestion is, of course, the most sensible one. And where better to hide than in plain sight?
Doing okay up there, Faf? I'm gonna take that as a yes.
Strom's here! I need my trading card. I'm gonna get his autograph for sure this time.
Okay. Ready?
Oh, there's 8 or 10 girls back home, and then maybe 20 or 30 on the road.
So, you're saying you're single?
Mr. the Slayer.
Please, call me Strom. Your book seems to be smoking.
Yes, yes. It's a filthy habit, but I can't get it to stop. I understand you've come to slay the dragon.
Yes!
I'm afraid I've already slain him.
Oh, darn the luck.
Mr. Strong?
Pathetic little specimen, isn't it?
Who are you calling pathetic?
I meant the dragon, not you, little human.
He guessed my species.
Are you positive he's slain? Completely. I've never seen a less slain dragon in all my life, but that's easily taken care of.
Ooh, the legendary golden triax! And here comes his famous battle cry.
Valim Vali!
Okay, the battle cry isn't all that great, but the axe is cool.
Stop!
I beg your pardon?
My hero, who's never been defeated in battle, and who's for sure gonna chop him up into little pieces. Eep!
No one stops Strom the Slayer from slaying!
But Faffy's a pet dragon!
Fine. I'll slay you, then your dragon. Alim Dali! Now, draw your sword, villain!
Don't worry, you can take this guy.
Really?
Of course not. Don't be stupid!
Alim Dali!
Can we discuss this? Ah! We're both reasonable people. Ah! I'm highly allergic to being chopped up. Ah!
What's going on?
The usual. Someone's trying to off Dave.
I'll put a stop to that. Clem thrust!
Do you have any idea what this is going to cost me in shoes?
Could we move to another part of the castle? I'm running out of things to hide behind.
Valim Vali!
Hold it! Nobody touches my official Strom the Slayer monkey warmer! Not even Strom the Slayer!
Oh, yeah? And what if I do, huh? What are you gonna do? You gonna stop me? Huh? Huh? Touch, 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 touch.
This at last is too much. Not even one's hero can be allowed to sully one's prized possession.
That does it!
Let's see. Hide, wait, favorite color, turn offs.
Ah! Weaknesses!
Touch, touch.
Aren't you gonna slay me anymore?
Obviously, you've never touched a monkey. It's kind of addicting.
All right, Strom. I challenge you to battle!
You?
but you're just a little... person?
I may be little, but I'm not as little as... your furry friend!
Mr. Squidgy!
Surrender or the bunny gets it!
No! Don't hurt Mr. Squidgy.
Promise not to touch my monkey warmer?
Promise!
Or slay Dave or Pappy?
Promise! Just give me back my bestest little pal. Mr. Squidgy, are you okay?
Are you okay, Z-Wazy?
Having lost all respect for her lifelong hero, Fang is finally able to ask...
Can I have your autograph?
Fang, your resourcefulness is impressive for one so small. Fare thee well, warriors of Udragoth. Fare thee...
And thus did Fang learn that even the greatest hero can be a...
weenie.
Hi-ya! Hi-ya!
Dave, I just found out Strong made them add a new trading card to the famous Barbarians collection. Maybe it's me. It could be me. Do you think it's me? Kronk as a smasher, junk. Mortad the ridiculer, junk. Strong the slayer, junk. Aha! It's... you!
Dave, the hider behind things?
Oh, that's not a flattering picture at all.
You got nothing to complain about.
Barbarian!
Bling Bling meets Ding-a-Ling. The Disney Channel original animated comedy series Brandy and Mr. Whiskers is coming up next. Here, only on Disney Channel.
Crazy Mr. Whiskers, the Jungle's most unlikely pair, on Disney Channel.
DCOM Extras takes you behind the scenes with Ali and AJ on the set of the Disney Channel original movie, Cowbells.
Take one, marker.
Hey, we're Ali.
We're Ali.
Oh, I won't say that.
You do? Okay, sorry.
I'm Allie.
And I'm AJ, and we are on the set of Cowbells. I play Courtney Callan.
My character is sisters with Courtney, and her name is Taylor.
Well, I think that Taylor and Courtney's relationship together is very, you know, similar to Allie and I's relationship.
With a fuzz. Sorry.
Okay. Yeah, you're fuzz-free. I don't see anything, dude.
What do I done here?
Some yogurt, milk, cheese.
But at the same time, they... fight a little bit more in this movie than AJ and I do in real life.
Courtney, give me that! No!
Uh-oh. Axe so strong, but he is still so weak!
Oh, really?
Ow! Son of a gun!
I think it's neat to, you know, be able to work with Allie and to be able to play sisters.
We've got to do our own stunts.
That was pretty cool.
That was really cool.
I think really at the end of the day, they really appreciate each other.
Which is exactly how Allie and I are in real life.
And we had fun making it, so if we had fun, then you guys will probably have fun watching it too.
Oh, like do a hug in camera? Cry! Watch Cowbells!
Don't miss the Disney Channel original movie, Cowbells, coming next month to Disney Channel.
Watching Disney Channel.
Surfers, it's time to go behind the scenes of the latest Disney movies.
Tim Allen stars in Disney's new movie, The Shaggy Dog.
Of course, you probably remember Tim Allen from the Santa Claus movies.
Only this time, he doesn't turn into old Saint Nick. He turns into, well, a shaggy dog.
And we got to talk to Tim about his canine capers.
In Disney's latest comedy, The Shaggy Dog...
What's happening to me?
Tim Allen transforms from family dad to family dog.
I'm clearly in a dream. Just gotta wake up.
Boom!
All right, I'm a dog.
And I got to sit down and talk to Tim.
Well, now that you have kind of a background as a dog, what would you say is the hardest part about being a dog?
Dogs are constantly distracted by odors. Then they get angry at other dogs immediately.
Fire!
When you're Dave, as a human, what traits do you have?
I really love chasing cats. I sense and smell things that humans can't smell. Like my wife's perfume, I know what it's made of, all the components of it.
Did I put on too much?
Oh, I like it.
How did you prepare for this?
I slept in a box and I ate kibble.
Did it work?
Yeah, I'm very dog-like. I'm wagging my tail right now, you just can't see it.
Thanks a lot for hanging out with us, Tim.
You bet.
Tim Allen stars in Disney's The Shaggy Dog, opening in theaters soon.
Shit. I meant the dog.
On stage, she's a superstar. But at home, she leads a totally regular life.
I'm telling Dad.
No, you're not.
She's got a pretty cool dad.
You guys think I'm being too tough on you?
Yeah.
That means I'm doing my job right.
And a pretty weird brother.
Time to turn in. Good thing I'm not an outie.
Yep, totally regular life.
Group hug.
Gotta go.
Hannah Montana premieres next month on Disney Channel.
Chug, chug, chug.
Channel. Woo! Who's a little like water and oil?
Brandy and Mr. Whisker.
What's in the kettle like ready to boil?
Brandy and Mr. Whisker.
Smelly rabbit, quack, quack, quack. Fell from a plane with no parachute.
Got stuck in the jungle, putting down roots.
Brandy and Mr. Whisker.
Side by side, different as day or night. But it's quite a ride, sharing our life with the trees. Nose to nose, they can be friends or foes.
Whether they're whining or minding their manners,
they're driving each other bananas. What will it take for your friendship to thrive?
Brandy and Mr. Whisker.
Can you avoid being eaten alive?
Brandy and Mr. Whisker.
Little cutie with your nose in the air.
You're really dramatic, aromatic hair.
Their bellies to fight, the faith that they share. Eat a social and brother and sister. Aye, 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 Brandy and Mr. Whisker.
Oh yeah, nothing like exercise to make you feel alive.
And why do I feel like I'm dying?
Hitting the wall, Whiskers?
Oh, there it is.
Check it out, boys! The hair's too slow for running in place!
Hold it. You're calling him slow?
Hey, what does a rabbit call a sloth running through molasses? The winner!
Whiskers, what's this loudmouth on a half-shell talking about?
Oh, the old race between a tortoise and a hare. You've heard the story, I'm sure. Hare gets the early lead, gets overconfident, enjoys a little nappy time, and, well...
I am on fire!
Wait, that really happened?
It happened. And tortoises have been making fun of us rabbits ever since.
Only because you losers! Come on, boys! Let's leave this slowpoke in our dust.
Okay, we gotta do something about this. You have to show that tortoise what you're made of.
Mr. Tortoise?
What? This better be important. I'm in the middle of wind sprints.
I have something to say to you.
So say it already! He's even slow getting to the point!
All right! That's enough, mister! For years, tortoises have mocked hares!
Well, I say no more! I draw the line here!
I wanna draw a rocket ship here, when I draw a monkey with a top hat and tails here!
Whiskers?
But the important one is a line here!
No more will you tortoises mock us hares!
Well, there's one way you could get us to stop. Race.
Race?
Be brave, Whiskers.
You won't race, because you know you'll lose.
I don't know that at all. And that is why I say, let's race!
Ladies' pantsuits, 50% off! Also, tortoise and hare to race.
Okay, let's train. 100-meter dash. Ready, set, go! .0002 seconds!
Dang! Oh, sorry that took so long. Ed needed some help moving his dresser.
Thanks, Mr. Whiskers!
Whiskers, that was great! You got this race in the bag!
Oh, no, Brandy. You don't know those tortoises. They have always got something new up their shells.
That new aerodynamic helmet is amazing! Look at him go!
Onward, men! We must get these scenic backdrops to the theater!
100-meter dash in just 58 hours! Oh, man! You've got this race in the bag!
I am winded!
Ready, set, go! Way to go, Whiskers!
Oh, man! This can't be happening! I can't lose to a rabbit! What do I do?
Simple. You hire Gaspar Le Gecko, the most devious man in all of the Amazon. You know that's me, right?
Yeah, that was implied.
Oh, good, good. Anywho, for a small fee, I can assure your victory.
So what do you want?
Oh, not much. Just, one of your delightful shells. Having your home on your back seems so, I don't know, cozy?
Mr. Le Gecko, you got a deal.
Whiskers, you can do this. Just run to the finish and don't look back.
Run back and don't finish. Got it.
Never mind, just don't think.
You're going down, rabbit. Oh, yeah? Well, take a good look at my tail, Tortoise, because that's all you're gonna see of me.
Dude, doesn't that hurt?
Gentlemen, I want to see a clean race. No shortcuts, no sneaky peats, no stinky dance, no shady sadies or anvaloopsies, and above all, no chainsaw cha-chas. Now, anyone seen our state-of-the-art starting device? On your marks! Get set!
Hold on to your hats! It's go time!
Go, Whiskers! Go! Woo!
Brandy? Brandy Harrington?
Yes?
Congratulations! You have been selected for a fabulous makeover.
Do I look like I need a makeover?
Honey, you don't need a makeover like I don't need this big tortoise shell.
That doesn't even make sense.
Did I mention it was free?
Retro, but this thing looks medieval.
The straps offer the pedicure. You wouldn't want your French tips to get all squeaky wiggly, would you?
I guess not.
You have played right into my evil clutchiness.
You tricked me, Gaspar! You of all people!
Yes, Whiskers won't dare win as long as I have you.
So, no manicure?
Actually, your cuticles could use a little work. Let me get my grabby bag, okay?
Gaspar's dogs, what are you guys doing here?
We're here to give you a message, Rabbit.
Oh boy, what is it, a singing telegram?
Oh, I wish, that'd be so nice. Think we can wing it?
Hey, Whiskers, don't you finish this race.
We want to see shame on your face.
We know you're gonna win soon.
But if you do, you'll never see Brandy a goon.
A goon?
What? It kind of rhymes.
No, it's not a word.
I think it was nice. Whiskers, what do you think?
Gosh, guys, it was the nicest threatening message I ever received.
See, he thought it was nice. Why do you always have to be so negative?
Okay, my lyrics come from my heart, okay? You just go for the cheap rhyme. I don't even know what you said.
Oh, no. Brandy.
Mr. Whiskers? Ooh, this is a bad sign when I can overtake you with a carefree saunter.
I just found out if I don't lose this race, I will never see Brandy a goon!
Is that even a word?
On the one hand, the pride of hares everywhere is at stake. On the other hand, so is the safety of my very best friend in the world. And on the third hand... Wait a minute, there's no third hand! Nothing's more important than Brandy. I have got to lose this race. But how am I gonna do that?
Well, your rival has to carry his house on his back. What if you tried that?
Any other ideas?
And now, back to our Muffy and Mr. Wackadoo Marathon!
Oh, Mr. Wackadoo, what zany mix-up will you do next?
It's no use! No matter how
how slow I am, the tortoise is slower! Come on, Whiskers, think, think! Wait, wait, could it be?
A brainstorm!
Okay, more of a brain drizzle, but the point is I don't have to lose! I could rescue Brandy!
Stand back, Ed! I've got a friend to save!
I know that silly bug is here somewhere. Just one more minuto.
Obedient school headmistress, forgive me for what I am about to do.
Ta-da! Oh, the tortoises are going to be furious. I must vanish from the face of the earth, hiding in a spot where neither man nor beast can ever hope to find me. Ooh, cozy.
All pretty colors.
They even match my shoes. Whiskers, wake up!
Oh, Brandy, I was just having the most amazing dream. I was racing a tortoise and you were being held captive, and then we ran into each other and knocked each other out, and for some reason there was a pirate?
That was no dream, matey. Yarr!
Did I lose?
Not yet, but almost. That way!
Men's hat and tie combos 50% off! Also, tortoise and hare tie.
Oh, I guess this competition was kind of pointless.
I guess.
Well, maybe our two species aren't so different after all. From now on, we'll live as equals.
Correction! Friends.
Daddy, I just met the coolest guy! Can he stay for dinner?
Not in my house!
Psst. We'll be right back with Brandy and Mr. Whiskers.
Next Friday.
I'm a working girl now, okay?
Well, Raven's big break.
I'm a designer!
Give her a big head.
I would like my design ship to grow.
And I'd like your butt out of my chair.
Catching all new, That's So Raven. Next Friday at 7:30, 6:30 Central on Disney Channel.
Speed ruled the day.
Don't you ever give up.
Nope. I just had breakfast.
Get going. Choose breakfast.
General Mills is a proud sponsor of Disney Channel, where good nutrition's an important part of every day. She's got family, she's got friends, and oh yeah, a few million fans. Meet Miley Stewart. She's one girl leading a double life.
I'm Hannah Montana.
Miley Stewart is Hannah Montana. Disney Channel's new original series, Hannah Montana, rocks on the Disney Channel next month.
Hi, I'm Spencer Breslin, and this is Shaggy.
Spencer and Shaggy co-star in Disney's new movie, The Shaggy Dog, starring Tim Allen as a man who lands in the doghouse.
What's happening to me?
That felt weird.
And Shaggy's going to teach me some of the tricks that Tim Allen had to learn to act like man's best friend.
It's called Top Dog Academy, where Shaggy will teach Spencer some new tricks.
I hope you won't be too rough on me, will you?
I had to bury that joke in the backyard.
Top Dog Academy is in session Saturday, March 4th, starting at 8, 7 Central on Disney Channel.
It's Mike's Super Short Show, where we show you what's new on Disney DVD.
Hey, everybody. We're talking about the all-new 2-disc 50th Anniversary Edition DVD, Lady and the Tramp.
This is the night. It's a beautiful night.
This classic Disney movie is all about the adventures of a pampered uptown cocker spaniel named Lady,
a streetwise downtown mutt named Tramp,
and their canine friends, Trusty and Jock.
Oh, Miss Lady.
Along the way, they discover what it's like to be in somebody else's paws.
Somebody kid!
This 2-disc DVD comes with a special feature called Disney's Virtual Puppy.
This feature allows anyone to adopt, train, and care for their own virtual puppies.
Cute little rascals.
They can even teach them to do tricks.
Oh, speaking of tricks, Sally and I combed the neighborhood for one talented dog, and now we'd like to present a very special segment called Super Duper Dog Tricks! Super Duper Dog Tricks!
Uh-oh!
Super Duper Dog Tricks!
Uh-oh!
Super Duper Dog Tricks!
Uh-oh!
Please welcome the incredible, the talented, the one and only Meatball! Meatball's first trick is called spaghetti and meatball.
Delicious.
Okay, meatball, do your
thing. Let's do this.
Hey!
Whoa, yeah. Good job, meatball.
Now meatball is gonna play some basketball.
Blimey!
This is one sweet meatball.
For sure. So this DVD comes with more bonus features like deleted scenes, a new music video, and virtual puppies.
Big thanks and high pause for Meatball coming on the show with us.
And now you know, because it's my show.
Lady and the Tramp, 50th Anniversary Edition, is coming soon to Disney DVD.
He's a cute little alien.
Thank you very much.
And she's his feisty little friend.
Yo.
Watch Lilo and Stitch the series, weekdays at 2-1 Central, right here on Disney Channel.
Now, let's get back to Brandy and Mr. Whiskers.
I cannot wait to get these shells home. There's a couple of ugly spots I have been dying to beautify.
You know, with all these shells, it might be really hard to walk and talk.
I'm beautifying. excuse me. You are totally in the middle of the path. Ew! Gross! You just got fox slime on my sandals! And a smart aleck too, huh? Looks like somebody needs to teach you some manners.
Oh, Pippi, I know lots of manners. If you tooty, say excuse me. If you pick it, never let us first.
Just get him!
Right. Ha ha! Ha! Now I will teach you to go! So, do you guys like sugar toad?
Hey there, Miss Brandy, what's going on?
Oh, just some frog business. Nothing Whiskers can't.
The frogs! The frogs! The frogs!
I know! Could they be any more rude?
Oh, Miss Brandy, you don't understand! Those are the notorious poison orange bumblebee frogs of prolonged sleep! One bite and Mr. Whiskers have fallen into a deep slumber for 50 years!
Okay, well, what about 56 tiny individual bites, huh?
Oh, come on, Ed. That's gotta be just some kind of jungle legend.
Ooh, would that were true, Miss Brandy. But jungle legends don't come complete with informative slideshows, like so. Once the orange venom enters the victim's bloodstream, he has but 24 hours before sleep will claim him for 50 years. Oh, grief. Oh, despair. Oh, profound sadness.
Wow, poor guy seems upset. 50 years is less than an hour, right?
Whiskers, I'm so sorry!
Well, I am feeling a tad sleepy. Maybe just a wee nippy-nappy, huh? Ow! What was that?
Well, I didn't have any cold water, so it worked with what I had. Oh, Whiskers, this is all my fault! Can you ever forgive me?
You think it's going to be that bad? I mean, 50 years isn't that long a time. What's the difference?
Yay! Sleep time over! Now I can play again. Oh, my back hurts and I am so tired. Plus, I gotta figure out how to pay my mortgage and feed my wife and 2.5 kids!
Well, look who decided to wake up! It's been 50 years since you took out the trash!
I want a torso!
Oh, I'm gonna be a grown-up! A boring, tired, no-fun-having grown-up! Do you know what this means? This is my last day of childhood! I have to pack every wacky adventure, every silly prank, every nutty childhood dream I have ever had into the next 24 hours! Good thing I made the comprehensive list yesterday afternoon. Oh boy, talk about your lucky timing! Ah, here it is. Things I want to do before I grow up.
I just want you to know, Whiskers, I am here for you, and I'm gonna help you make that list a reality. Whatever you need me to do.
Number one, kiss a pretty girl. Let's see, that'll involve my lips.
Hey, you know, I have a great idea. Why don't we save that one till the end? You know the best for last? Eat weight in hot dogs. Ew!
I am pleased as a tropical fruit punch that you have chosen to dine with me on such a tragic occasion. I am offering you a discount.
Well, that's very nice of you, Gaspar. 5% off his next visit? Gaspar, that's 50 years from now! And this coupon expires in 2 weeks!
Not valid with any other discounts. Offer void in Alaska, Hawaii, and Puerto Rico.
I think we might want to go directly to activity number 4.
What was that?
Come on, Brandy.
Help me on the big finale.
Yeah!
Finally, Beethoven's fifth as the maestro meant it to be heard. Make a basket.
Closer. Closer. Closer.
Yay! Life-size marshmallow replica?
Oh, Ed.
I don't know what to say.
You've made me edible!
Star in TV series?
This is Muffy and Mr. Wackadoo, scene 16, take 1. And action!
Mr. Wackadoo! If you're shaving with the sour cream, then what did you put on my baked potato?
Wackadoo! Wackadoo!
Just think, all this is gonna change so much in 50 years. The trees will die, these flowers will wilt, those mountains will shrivel up and blow away.
Actually, mountains keep pretty well.
Oh, dear naive Brandy. Dreaming doesn't make it so.
So when do we find a pretty girl to give me a little smoochacho, huh?
I don't know if that's gonna be... Oh, hey, look, we're home!
Home? What are we gonna do there?
Gee, I guess it'll have to be a...
Surprise! All my friends! And...
some sheep.
We just thought we'd stop by in case you had a tough time falling asleep.
Thanks, guys, but after all the fun I've had today, I can fall asleep on a bed of nails.
Oh, I wish you'd mentioned that earlier. We got you one of these instead. We all chipped in. I said I'd pay you back.
Oh, Brandy!
Of course it is. It is the new Gaspalpedic 186 Comfort Rest mattress, recommended by the jungle's most respected sleep authorities.
Hello. I sleep almost 20 hours a day, and I just...
And I picked out the pillow.
Wow, it's so soft. What's inside? Duck feathers? Goose down?
Yo, Cheryl, got a sec?
I'm actually feeling sleepy now, but you guys, understand, party.
Whiskers, is there anything you'd like to say before you go to sleep?
Yes, there is. Don't put shaving cream on my hand or stick it in warm water, okay? Oh, you mean something that stupid? Well, I got to do a lot of fun and exciting stuff today. I mean, a game of extreme freestag. Woohoo!
Oh, that was touch and go for a while. Am I right, Robin?
But in the end, I realized all that stuff on my list didn't matter.
What? I just spent the entire day running around and doing every idiotic thing you can imagine. And you say it didn't matter? How could the list not matter?
Well, because all I wanted was to spend time with my best friend in the world, Brandy Harrington.
Oh, Whiskers?
Of course, you're still item number one. That one I have got to have now.
Let's see where I can find a pretty girl.
Who's willing to kiss me?
I got it.
That looks a pretty chap. You wouldn't even know.
I have to rearrange my sock drawer.
Oh, well. I gave it a try.
I hope I qualify as a pretty girl.
Only the prettiest in the entire universe.
Whiskers, I am so sorry. I never meant for this to happen. I know you can't hear me, but I just hope that in your 50 years of dreams, you get to have even half as much fun as I've had sharing this jungle with you. Oh, why did I ever send you after that orange frog with black stripes?
Wait a minute! Orange frog with black stripes? That's what beat Whiskers?
What about it?
That's just an ordinary tree frog. Poison orange bumblebee frogs of prolonged sleep are black with orange stripes.
No. I do believe orange with black stripes are the bad ones.
Don't you remember the rhyme? Orange with black, you're okay, Jack. Black with orange, you're about to go to sleep for 50 years, so you might want to eat an orange.
You know, you're right. How did I ever forget that catchy ditty?
Wait, hold up.
You mean I just kissed that flea ball for nothing? Ew!
Oh, boy, 50 years of sleep is not the thing for a trick back.
Whiskers, you were only asleep for a...
Dear sweet Brandy, my old friend, is that really you? Oh, Father Time has been so cruel to your once beautiful looks. You're still here. Oh, I was sure your fast-paced lifestyle would take you before your time. So, what wonders has the future brought us? Do we have jetpacks, electric soup, our first amphibian president? And where is my robot butler? Already old?
So if, say, I wanted him out for 50 more years?
Black with orange stripes.
Right. Come on, Whiskers, we're going on a nature hike.
Oh, splendid. I'll have Reginald bring around the hover car. Already old?
Never mind, I can't wait.
And you're watching Disney Channel.
Whatever you are, pal. I'm Maggie Pesky. Remember that name, because one day... I'm gonna be a famous rock star. But today, I play for free. So sit back, relax, and get ready for some rockin' tune skis.
Hey, Max. I see you found a quiet, totally deserted place to practice.
Yeah, right.
Well, I won't bug you. I'll just keep joyously skipping along.
Whoa, Pewpie. What are you so happy about?
Well, there's this fly in my class.
You've got a crush? That is so cute.
No, Lucy's cute. She's got big eyes, a pretty smile, hairy legs.
When do I get to meet this lucky bug?
Right after I do. I kinda haven't talked to her yet.
Pewpie, she'll never know you like her if you don't say anything.
I know, but I'm way too shy to talk to her. So, I wrote a song, and I'm gonna sing it to her tomorrow at show and tell instead. Then, she'll finally notice me.
Wow.
be. You want to really impress Lucy? Have a real live rock star sing your song.
But I don't know any rock stars. Oh, I get it. You know some rock stars. Could you talk to them? Or you could sing my song to Lucy. That would be awesome.
I'd be happy to, little bro.
Great, because we'll never get a real rock star by tomorrow.
You bite up my heart like toxic waste growing in the dark. Every time that you're near, my heart goes aflutter. We're losing the crowd. Tony the Big Green Tick had a nose that he loved to fit. Tony the Big Green Tick had a nose that he loved to pick. Tony the Big Green Tick had a nose that he loved to fit. Tony the Big Green Tick had a nose that he loved to pick.
Maggie, what happened?
Wasn't it fantabulous? I totally connected with my audience.
You were awesome!
Yuck, I just kind of slug. Ugh.
But why'd you stop singing my song?
I mean, Tony the Big Green Tick! That was gold, baby! And I just made it up. What a rush!
It's just, you were supposed to...
You first? I'm having a birthday party tomorrow, and I was wondering...
Oh, boy, here it comes!
If your sister could play at my party, could you, Maggie? Please, 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 please! Almost totally uber-famous rock star. Zebra, leopard, or twinkle legs?
Whatever.
You're right. If one bird's out, they all go. I'm going with leopard.
Have fun at Lucy's party. I'll be in my room, alone, in the dark.
Oh, Pupi. I meant to finish your song. I really did. It's just...
Bring me back a piece of rotten cake and, maybe a new heart to replace this broken one. But only if they have them.
I know. You can come with me and be my roadie. You know, lug my guitar, my amp, all my equipment.
Gee, sounds great.
That way, you'll be with me when I sing your song at Lucy's very own birthday party, which makes it like a birthday present.
Yippee!
Let's go get your girl. Ahem.
Oh, right.
Anymore and I may start cramping.
Man, these opening acts always stink.
We want Maggie! We want Maggie! We want Maggie!
Hey, I'm gonna finish my 20 minutes whether you brats like it or not!
You're gonna play my song this time, right, Maggie?
Of course! You're not just my roadie, you're my brother. I thought I told you to tune this.
You know, Maggie, you know what those kids out there love about you the most?
My talent?
Nope.
My look?
Nope.
My hair color?
Nope. What these kids love about you is that you skip the sappy love songs and go right to the stuff that matters most to them in their lives. You know, like, boogers. He had a nosy love to pick. Ah, that song gets me every single time.
The little monsters are all yours.
All right, everybody! Who's ready to pick their nose?
Besties are in the pool!
Here, hold this for me.
I don't know that lucky kick.
Yeah, this too.
He said you'd kiss you, but he said I don't need to. I want to put my brothers on my sleeve. Tony the big kick, na 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 na. Okay, you've all been great. I just got one very special song to sing before I go.
Goody.
Tony the kick.
I sang that already.
Tony the kick. Tony the Tick! Tony the Tick!
Sing it, or we'll tell our mommies!
We'll tell our mommies! We'll tell our mommies! We'll tell our mommies!
You didn't sing it!
I know, I'm sorry, I...
You promised, and you promised, and you promised, and you still didn't do it!
I know, but it's just... I'm too big now!
Everybody expects me to be a certain way. I'm afraid if I sing it now, they'll all turn against me.
Oh, well, then I guess you won't sing it for me here either.
Cheesy McBuzzy calls? They want me to perform in their family-style restaurant and arcade? Man, that's like spaghetti big time. Next stop, small tours across the world. So basically, yes, you're right. I won't sing your song at Cheesy McBuzzy. But I've got an idea. Tomorrow, you bring Lucy to the playground, and I'll sing your song to just the two of you. With no one else around to hear me do it. Absolutely no one. At all. No one.
Just the two of us?
It's gonna be your moment, kiddo. I won't let you down.
Oh, it's Maggie Pesky!
We love you, Maggie!
My name is Tony. I'm a tick, and I really do have a nose I love to pick.
Look, I'm sorry, but I've got to be somewhere. I'll see you all at my concert tonight, okay?
Yikes, I can't get away. Yikes, what can I say? Yikes, the price of fame is bringing me down. Yikes, won't you leave me alone? Yikes, I should have known. It's hard to sing your song when they're all around. Yikes, the price of fame is bringing me down.
Hubert, I'm so sorry. I got here as soon as I could. Please don't hate me.
Yeah, whatever.
But I'll still see you at the show tonight, right? My big break, remember? Pee-o-pee! This is a song someone special to me wrote for someone special to him. It's not about boogers, but a promise is a promise. This goes out to Lucy.
Every time that you're near, my heart goes a-flutter. I've never seen such beauty, not even in the gutter.
What is this line?
Don't buzz away. The Buzz on Maggie will be right back. You can go to DisneyChannel.com right now and check out American Dragon Jake Long.
I'm all over that.
There you can test your dragon skills with Jake's firepower games. What's new now? Design personal calendars, greeting cards, and much more. Print them out and trade them with your friends. Then, click into the All-Star Skate Park, where you can choose Jake or Trixie and show off your mad skater skills. Log on to DisneyChannel.com and get fired up with American Dragon Jake Long online.
Okay, guys, whose turn is it to do the dishes? No one watches TV until the dishes are done.
Cat Mom, homework.
I gotta save the world.
I did the dishes last night. Hey, that was me!
I'll do it!
Well, thank you, London. That's very nice of you to volunteer.
No, wait, I didn't say that.
Thank you, London.
This fall, make room for more Disney Channel.
Weekdays. Get loud for the crowd.
What? Yeah!
Proud Family, weekdays at 5:30, 4:30 Central on Disney Channel.
Get ready for the totally remixed Bill of the Future.
I need to figure out my life. I need to make plans. I need to dance.
Jenkins.
Hey.
Bill of the Future. Weekdays at 6:30, 5:30 Central on Disney Channel.
It's amazing.
Cool. Any bites?
Nope.
Let's do some fishing.
Disney Channel's Express Yourself is sponsored by Twisted Cheetos Snacks. Make a splash by expressing yourself every day. And now, Disney Channel's Express Yourself.
Friends are a big part of my life. They understand and they give me good advice. They keep me grounded.
Some friends that I've had since like first grade. Some of them I met before I was an actor, and they've never really treated me any differently.
My real friends don't treat me any differently. No, they don't. They just think it's cool that I'm on television. I've kind of always been entertaining my friends, so it's pretty much the same thing to them.
Friends are amazing. My friends are so random. I love it.
We could do anything and we would have a good time.
And I love, like, when we're talking. You know, we talk about nothing. We talk about everything.
But we're always just laughing and just having fun together.
So, yeah, it's a lot of fun.
Like, I had one person that's in my life that I would consider a friend. And if that person was to vanish, all of a sudden, I would be lost.
I don't think without my friends, I could get through it. I know they're always there for me.
The best friends and the longest friends that you're going to have are there for you forever.
Disney Channel. Express yourself.
When good gossip leads to bad things.
$10 million just disappeared.
Lexi's gotta go totally undercover. Get a Clue, a Disney Channel original movie starring Lindsay Lohan. Monday at 8, 7 Central on Disney Channel.
Here we go. Back to the buzz on Maggie.
Students, I need your complete and undivided attention. This is the last line of the play, and as your director, I can't stress enough how important it is. My kingdom. I mourn my kingdom.
Oh, 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 Mr. Fluxbit, I've got a fantastic idea.
Oh, really? So do I. Mind if I go first?
Not at all. Let her rip.
My idea is that... You keep your ideas to yourself!
Okay, now my turn.
No! If we are to finally triumph at this year's Royal Insect Academy Drama Contest, it is my way.
Or the flyway! Eugene, you're off your mark. Move it!
But I really like where Eugene's standing. An inspired choice.
Really?
Mr. Bugs, speak. Can we talk about my part? What are my character's motivations? Her hopes. A dream!
Raina, for the last time, you are playing a rock. Just lie there.
Now you see, Mr. Bugsbit, that's just the kind of thinking that makes us lose this contest every time. Remember our last competition?
To flee or not to flee, that is the question.
We've got to think outside the box if we're going to win this time. Why can't a rock have dreams? Why can't a tree sing?
Why can't a tree sing?
I'm glad you asked. I'm strong to be at home. I've got a strong support. Yeah, I'm strong to be at
home. Maggie, dear,
why are you looking at the cable?
After today's rehearsal, I've got to let my creativity out somehow.
But, dear, you're knitting spaghetti.
Oh, well, here you go, Pubert.
Thanks! Do you have this in a linguine?
Mr. Bugsbit wants to win so badly that he's squelching our creativity! Doesn't he realize that the way to make a play great is to accept everyone's ideas?
What are you talking about? He's the director. The director's like the quarterback. He's got to be completely in charge.
And what do you know about it? Have you ever directed a play?
No, but at least Bugsbit and I have both been in charge of stuff, which is more than anybody can say for you.
Oh, yeah? So that's why I'm going to direct my own play. One where everyone's ideas count, not just the director's.
I think it's really great. It's great. Oh, yeah.
So, you mean if I stand in a slightly different place, you won't yell at me?
Eugene, in my play, you can stand wherever you want.
No bully.
And a rock can have hopes and dreams. Whatever its little rock heart desires. Rock on!
Maggie Pesky, I thought I kicked you out of this play.
You may have kicked me out of this play, Mr. Bugsbit, but you haven't kicked me out of this competition. I'm going to be there with my own version of King Flear, and it's going to kick yours in the thorax. Who's with me?
Yeah! Yeah!
Oh, it's on.
Now, since this is our first rehearsal, I want everyone to remember one thing. We're here to be creative and have fun. The only rule is no rules. Eugene, where's your mark?
No, I'm standing right on it, I swear.
Yeah, but you don't have to, remember?
Go, I'm on a tingle.
I've got an idea, but you probably wouldn't want to do it.
Hey, I can't use an idea unless I hear it.
Well, I know I'm the palace guard, and I'm supposed to say, hark, who goes there? But I was thinking, what if instead I say, yo, my peeps, what up?
You should pop guard. Hop to it.
All right. Word to your mother.
And I've decided my rock dreams of being a Kung Fu Mermaid Princess.
And I say we make its dreams come true.
Wow, let's hear it for Maggie. This is going to be the best play ever.
Woo! Yes, what a song.
Thanks, guys. I used to be a proud oak. Now I'm just a weeping fool.
What is this?
A little advertisement for my play.
Come see the next winner of the Royal Academy Drama Contest, King Flear. Sounds like an advertisement for my play.
Keep reading.
Maggie Pesky's cool version, not Mr. Bugspit's stinky version.
Sorry, Mr. B, but my play's a full-on creativity explosion. Your play's so lame, it couldn't even beat Miney the Pantomime Bug. Miney! I'm sorry. I had no idea you were right there.
Perhaps we should leave the results for the judges to decide.
Perhaps, or perhaps you should stop on by and witness my directing genius for yourself.
Lead the way.
Don't buzz away. The Buzz on Maggie will be right back.
It's Mike's Super Short Show, where we show you what's new on Disney DVD.
Hi, everybody. Welcome to the big show from the Big Apple. I'm here in New York City at the premiere of the Cinderella Special Edition DVD. So let's see how Sally's doing. Hey, Sally. How's everything going?
Just great. I just took out the trash, and now I'm doing your laundry.
Sorry, I can't be there. Well, I gotta go, okay? Bye.
Wait. Hold on, Mike. No. Stupid laundry. I wish I could go to the premiere.
Oh! Hello! I'm your fairy god neighbor!
Fairy god neighbor?
Yeah, just go with it. I'm here to send you to the ball premiere!
Awesome!
Bibbidi bobbidi boo!
Wow! Oh my gosh!
Hey, how'd you get here?
Magic! Let's go! Which thing do you remember most from Cinderella?
Oh, goodness.
The ball.
The ball, and I think the transformation scene.
Which is the glass slipper.
It's the classic scene.
What's your Cinderella story?
I was just some normal little kid from New Jersey, and then I just came here.
The DVD comes with the Royal Life Design Studio game, so what would you design your own palace like?
Mine would look cool. Mine would look like a mall with a bed.
Hey, guys, I have this glass slipper here, and, I was thinking maybe you guys could try it on.
See, you're too little.
It doesn't fit all the way.
Does it?
Well, the movie's about to start.
Let's go see the all-new digital restoration of Cinderella.
Cinderella.
And now you know, because it's
my Super Short Show. The Cinderella Special Edition DVD is available now on Disney DVD.
Celebrate Phil of the Future Fan Appreciation Day with the Phil of the Future Marathon. Starting at 6/5 Central, watch for the secret question in each episode. Then submit your answers at DisneyChannel.com/Phil. Your email might appear live on TV. It all starts Friday at 6/5 Central on Disney Channel.
Disney Channel gives kids a chance to show their stuff.
Hi, I'm Jessica and I collect postcards. I think that it's so much fun to collect postcards because it's a great way to see different places around the world. This one over here was from when we went to the U.S. Virgin Islands. I love that trip. It's fun and it's somewhere I'd like to go back. When I find a new postcard, it's like getting a birthday present. When my parents or friends, they get postcards, I like to see where they've been and what it's like where they go. My friend went to Utah, and I've always liked Utah, all the snow, and when the Olympics were there, and Salt Lake City, so I'd like to visit there someday. My dad went to the Peabody Hotel in Memphis. I think it's really cool that they have ducks walking around in the hotel, so I'd like to visit that place someday. I plan to go a lot of places when I get older. I think I will keep collecting all my life. I like remembering where I've been.
If you collect something you think is cool, share with us at DisneyChannel.com/stuff. Kids show their stuff on Disney Channel.
Here we go. Back to the Buzz on Maggie.
Watch and learn. Watch and learn.
Okay, people, places.
Yeah, they probably didn't hear me.
Oh, delicious.
Eugene, what are you doing way back here? Go stand on your mark.
Oh, but I decided this should be my new mark. Pretty cool, huh?
Well, Eugene, I respect your artistic vision and all, but you're not even on the stage.
You said I could stand wherever I want.
Yeah, I know, but...
Yo, Maggie, I thought it would be cool if the guard did a hip-hop dance. What do you think?
With that music, no one will hear the dialogue.
Maggie, you said all ideas are accepted. I am doing my dance.
Well, if Wendell gets into a lame dance, then so do I.
Now, boys!
The dance is my thing. You're not doing it.
Oh, and who's gonna stop me? Some hip-hop guard?
Stand straight, my brother.
These feet take orders from no man.
Your feet ain't so tough now, are they?
Well, Miss Pesky, bravo!
Not a problem. I've got everything under control. Just a little healthy creative debate. Perfectly normal.
Watch it, Eugene!
I know what we need. A Kung Fu Mermaid Princess Rivalry.
Well, I'm very impressed. Unfortunately, the competition is amateur drama, not amateur wrestling. I'd better go. I have an acceptance speech to write.
Maggie, are you okay?
It's Director Maggie, and things are going to be different. I'm not losing this competition to Bug Spit.
Well, Maggie, I just thought...
Did I tell you to speak? Did I tell you to think? No!
I'm the director, and what I say goes. Now, just in your places.
But you said all our ideas mattered.
I also said that I can't use an idea I haven't heard.
Okay. Well, here's my idea. I say this.
Sorry. Didn't hear a word.
But...
Policers! No!
My kingdom. I'm worried for my kingdom.
Again. But this time...
Try acting!
And Eugene, you are 3 millimeters off your mark.
No, I'm not.
I stand corrected, Eugene. 3.5 millimeters off your mark.
Move it!
Maggie, what are you doing?
Shaping this play up, that's what. At least now we have a chance of beating Bug Spit.
But that's not what we signed up for. We signed up to have our ideas.
Okay, let's have a big hand for the termites and their production of Long Day's Journey into Paneling.
Yay! Oh, we're neat.
Finally, bravo! Now we have our play. And just barely in time for us to go out there and crush Bug Spit.
You mean the way you've crushed our spirits?
What? What are you talking about?
You got us all excited, telling us you'd use our ideas. But now you've stopped using them completely. You're even worse than Bug Spit. You got so caught up in beating him, you lost sight of why we did this in the first place.
Okay, tell you what. Why don't you all agree on one idea, just one, that'll make you all feel better, and I promise to allow it, whatever it is.
I don't know.
Okay, we got it. Ready to hear our idea?
Ready.
Oh, may I see that first?
Believe it!
Weeping? Wait, but I... How can thou abandon me? Eugene, Wendell... Sweetest Rena, all is lost. My kingdom,
I mourn for my kingdom. I'm stoked to be an oak. I've got a trunk.
Take your seats, everyone. We're about to announce our winner.
Mind if I sit here?
I guess not.
Sorry I got so out of hand.
Oh, it's all right. And I'm sorry I gave away your bike.
The winner of the Royal Insect Academy Drama Contest is King Flear, directed by Smiley, the pantomime bug.
What?
Even your play was better than that guy's.
Why, thank you. And I must admit that I quite respect what you were trying to do, even if you did fail abysmally.
Be quiet!
The Buzz on Maggie presents a scene from episode 118.
It was cold today!
How cold was it?
It was so cold, I had to wear boots!
Boots. I love that kid.
The Buzz on Maggie, new episode next Saturday at 5:30, 4:30 Central on Disney Channel.
Your brother's a legend.
Donnie Stevens, muscles that bolt.
Your sister's perfect.
Lately, you've been excessively upbeat.
Thanks! So, how do you get noticed? Just be yourself.
This is potentially my greatest undertaking ever.
That's what Louis Stevens does.
Prepare to be amazed, guys.
This one's called Lobster Attack!
Wow. Wow.
Be yourself and watch Even Stevens, coming up next on Disney Channel.
Always a pleasure.
Hi, I'm Stephen Anthony Lawrence, and he's from Even Stevens, and you're watching Disney Channel. Ta-da!
As opposed to this?
I happen to be flosser-sizing, right?
Oh, you know what? This is really ridiculous, even for you.
For your information, flosser-sizing contains the benefits of dental hygiene as well as a full aerobic workout. And I think people will pay dearly for that.
Someone is gonna pay dearly for that, all right, you weirdo?
Ah! Ah! Got it out there!
Okay.
La plume de ma tante est dans le bureau de mon oncle.
The plum in my pants? That can't be right.
Donnie! Me! It's the Bride of Flossenstein!
You are the most infuriating...
You're infuriating!
Hey, look. I have one day to learn French.
That's realistic.
Don't worry, Ren won't disturb you anymore. Just make sure Miss Prissy Pants respects my floss time.
Well, when I get my hands on you, you will not have teeth left to floss!
Is that a threat?
Drop it!
Guys! Hold it! You guys need to see this.
What? You lifting weights in your bathing suit? We already saw that.
Oh. I mean this.
Cut it out! It's my chair! Always look at chair!
Will you guys cut it out? Look, I was trying to take the football game last week,
but I got this instead.
Welcome back to Sibling Sessions. Now, Kevin, I want you to turn to your sister, Wendy. I want you to tell her from your heart, okay? The real reason why you treat her the way you do.
Kevin, you're in way over your head, man. Get out.
Shh. Can I hear this?
It's nothing against you, Wendy. You're the best. I guess the reason I act the way I do is because of my own insecurities. Deep down, I'm just a loser.
That Kevin guy is a disgrace to brothers everywhere.
You know, they film that right here in Sacramento. You guys should go in for an audition.
I'm in for that. I mean, that host seems really insightful. No,
there is nothing in the world that would make me go on that show.
And for appearing on our show today, Kevin and Wendy will receive two tickets to Happy Mountain Amusement Park. That's Happy Mountain. A whole big heap of fun or your money back.
Happy Mountain, Daddy like it.
That's Bobby.
Mm-hmm.
Right here. You see? He's fitted in it like a new car.
Try to keep your disappointment in check, Rin. It's only your oldest and dearest friend, Nilsen.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was just expecting Bobby.
I know. That's why I'm here. He called me and asked me to tell you that he had to cancel. He had some work to finish up with his lab partner or something.
Oh, I wonder why I didn't just call.
He tried. I tried. Your phone's out of order.
Really? Out of order?
Happy Mountain, the big old rock of fun!
Louis, what did you do to my phone?
Your phone. About that, yeah. No, don't worry, Ren's phone is totally waterproof. Hello? Hello?
The shower?
All right. Hey, save it for the show.
Oh, excuse me, Nelson. I gotta get back to work.
Bonjour, comment allez-vous?
Bonjour, comment allez-vous?
What are you trying to do?
I'm studying French. I got this date tomorrow with this beautiful foreign exchange student.
Bonne chance, mon ami.
Hey, did you know you speak French?
Yeah. I spent 2 summers at French camp. I thought it was going to be something else, but it turned out to be okay.
Hey, you want to come on my date with me to translate?
You want me to go on the date with you? But what if she says something, you know, personal?
Well, you can still translate. Just plug your ears.
Right. Thanks for taking me to Nurse Phil.
Sure. How'd you do that?
Well, I was just trying to see if it was possible to give myself a wedgie. Turns out I can. Oh, I feel so much better.
That's really weird. So, how do you get your arm to bend like that?
I have a flexated skeletal structure. In layman's terms, I'm double-jointed. I hope it comes in handy later in life. Listen! Thanks, Ren. Guess I won't be needing Nurse Phil.
In the science lab. It's Bobby.
And Mandy always gets her man Sanchez.
He did not tell me that he was her lab partner.
He failed to mention that part on the phone.
Hi, Bobby.
Hey, Ren.
Mandy. Ren? Love the lipstick. That color works so well on your thin lips. You know, I really wonder what it would look like on a fat lip.
Okay, Ren, don't you need to talk to Bobby about that thing?
Oh, the thing. Yeah, excuse me, just a second. I need to talk to my boyfriend. Okay, why didn't you tell me that Mandy was your lab partner?
I don't know. I didn't think it'd matter. Does it matter?
Yeah, she's totally flirting with you.
Hey, come on. It's just Mandy. I mean, she does it with everyone.
Yeah, I guess you're right. I guess I'm just overreacting.
So, I'll see you later?
Of course.
Don't worry about it. Don't worry about it.
They just can't cancel. Where am I supposed to find two bickering siblings at a moment's notice?
You tripped me.
Now, why would I do that? It's not like you got goopy ice cream in my hair.
Did it ever occur to you that your hair got in my ice cream? Did that enter your skull?
Hello. I'm David Blackburn.
Sir, yeah, I'm Louis Stevens. This is Cruella.
Great. Look, you're going in 5 minutes, okay? And save the delightful squabbling for the cameras, huh?
Wait, Mr. Blackburn? We just came in here for an interview and you want us on the show right now?
Sir, excuse me, when I win the tickets for Happy Mountain, do I get some kind of VIP pass or something? Like, can I cut all the lines or do I gotta wait for the slobs? What's the deal, huh?
Wait a second. This is Sibling Sessions, right? What happened to the dignified set?
It's trashed. Sibling Sessions is now Sib Wars. We kind of stunk in the ratings, so we had to jazz up the format. Happens to everyone. Here, the 6 o'clock news is getting jousting sticks. Hare, baby, Hare!
That's huge.
Thank you. All right. Is my hair on straight?
It's good.
Karen!
So Ren made the best man win.
No, forget this, okay? Sibling Sessions was a forum for intelligent discussion. Sib Wars? Come on, it's just a cheesy game show.
And you're afraid of losing to me in front of everyone.
I'm sorry, what did you...
You're afraid of losing to me in front of everyone.
Okay, because there is nothing in the world that you could possibly beat me at. I could even grow a mustache before you.
You could? In fact, it's coming in quite nicely.
Okay, you want to throw down with your big sis?
Okay, you're invading my space right now.
Do you?
Because you want a piece of me?
You're in my bubble. You want a piece of me?
I want to throw down like
you
this.
You do?
I want
you
a chunk of you.
Okay,
you got a piece.
Okay, hold me back, because I'm coming at you.
No, I know.
Fine!
Stick around. Disney Channel's original series, Even Stevens, will be right back.
It's Mike's Super Short Show, where we show you what's new on Disney DVD.
Hey, everybody. We're talking about the all-new 2-disc 50th Anniversary Edition DVD, Lady and the Tramp.
This is the night. It's a beautiful night.
This classic Disney movie is all about the adventures of a pampered uptown cocker spaniel named Lady,
a streetwise downtown mutt named Tramp,
and their canine friends, Trusty and Jock.
Oh, Miss Lady.
Along the way, they discover what it's like to be in somebody else's paws.
Some fun, eh, kid?
This 2-disc DVD comes with a special feature called Disney's Virtual Puppy.
This feature allows anyone to adopt, train, and care for their own virtual puppies.
Cute little rascals.
They can even teach them to do tricks.
Oh, speaking of tricks, Sally and I combed the neighborhood for one talented dog, and now we'd like to present a very special segment called Super Duper Dog Tricks. Please welcome the incredible, the talented, the one and only Meatball! Meatball's first trick is called Spaghetti and Meatball.
Delicious.
Okay, Meatball, do your
thing. Let's do this.
Hey!
Woo, yeah, good job, Meatball.
Now Meatball is going to play some basketball. Woo! Oh, hey, yeah. Put it in!
Oh, yeah! Blimey!
This is one sweet Meatball.
For sure.
My.
So this DVD comes with more bonus features like deleted scenes, a new music video, and virtual puppies.
Big thanks and high paws for Meatball coming on the show with us.
And now you know, because it's my show.
Lady and the Tramp, 50th Anniversary Edition, is coming soon to Disney DVD.
Disney Channel gives kids a chance to show their stuff.
Hi, my name is Angelica, and I collect bugs. I wanted a bug collection after I learned about so many of them, but my mom does not like bugs. She said the only way I can have a bug collection is if they were fake. There's so many different kinds of bugs, and they each do things differently, like how they walk, how they eat, what they eat, where they live. They're just so cool. They're adorable to me. I'm really into my collection. It's so cool what all these bugs can do and how they live. This one is called the tomato hornworm. As you probably know, this is a cockroach. Okay, this may sound a little weird, but it can live 3 weeks with its head off. Some people can't stand the sight of spiders and stuff, but they're really cool. Like, they're not hurting you. They help you. They eat ants. Even though they may be annoying, they catch the flies in your house. If people took the time to, like, read and learn about bugs, they wouldn't be so afraid of them. When I get a new part of my collection, it makes me excited to, like, find a new place for it, where I'll fit in. It's just really exciting for me. You can learn a lot from what you're collecting. Maybe you can make new friends by collecting. Like, you can meet people who are into what you're collecting, and it's just really cool.
If you collect something you think is cool, share with us at disneychannel.com/stuff. Kids show their stuff on Disney Channel.
And now back to Disney Channel's original series, Even Stevens.
Welcome to the new and improved Sib Wars, with your host, the handsome, the talented, David Blackburn!
That's me! Let's meet our battling Sibs,
Lewis and Rin Stevens! All right,
Rin, why don't you tell me a little something about your brother?
Oh, well, he's in seventh grade. He eats cereal through his nose, and he wears my mother's slippers.
Wait, let me make that clear. I only wear them because they're cozy.
We're not here to judge, okay?
Right.
Mama's slippers. Lewis, tell me a little something about Rin here.
Rin's in the eighth grade. She alphabetized her underwear, and she has webbed feet.
I do not have webbed feet.
Really? Ren, then explain to me the skin between
what?
The toes.
You should not be
Why don't
even
you
looking?
Explain to me what that is there?
Don't even look at my toes.
I don't want you to talk anymore.
You're a toe lover.
You are.
Okay. That's good stuff. Let's get started.
Round one.
Brain Busters, where we're going to test your knowledge on a variety of subjects.
See ya.
Ow! Our categories are funny fat guys, things that smell like other things, pranks on grandma.
Excuse me, what is this? This is stupid.
And our last category, this is stupid. Now, this involves things that are really, really stupid. All right, Lewis, you're the youngest. You choose first.
I'll take funny fat guys, Dave Lush.
This comic.
Chris Farley.
That is correct. Next category.
Well, Dave Rooney, I'll take pranks on grandma.
You're at Thanksgiving dinner.
Hiding her dentures inside the turkey.
Amazing. That is correct.
Pattern in orthopedic shoes. Animals dress as humans. That's my favorite one.
Okay, welcome back. The score for the end of round one is Lewis Stevens, 500. Rin Stevens,
0.
It's time for round two. The Pudding Pit of Doom! Rin Stevens, this is your chance to catch up. They will both walk out onto the plank. The objective to this game is to force your opponent into the tub of generic pudding-like substance. You have to use trickery, evil facial expressions, or a combination of the two. Oh, and watch for hidden surprises. The last one standing wins 500 points!
Prepare to plunge, pudding boy.
That's the spirit.
Ready? And go!
Hey, Ren, when you fall in the pudding, your web feet are going to come in handy.
Oh, really? Yeah. Really? Really?
Yeah.
You know, Lewis, this is really ridiculous. You win. I'm out of here.
What are you talking about? Are you leaving?
No!
You can't beat me. I'm the prince of the plank, Ren. Can't beat me. No, I'm the prince of the plank. Unfortunately, that's not the best tasting pudding. The score is now tied, but we're out of time. Lewis and Rin will be back tomorrow for the final round, where they'll have 60 seconds to humiliate each other. And I encourage you both to get nasty.
Sandrine, you are very pretty.
Sandrine, to treasure you.
Merci.
Thank you.
Le poulet est très magnifique. Et le pomme de terre.
Dude, she's blowing kisses at me.
What'd she say?
She really likes the food.
Oh.
And that she's never seen an American man with such handsome features.
For real?
No.
Et qu'est-ce qu'elle a dit?
Et la langue télésance de croissant de beurre.
Hey, Nelson, why don't you run along? I can take it from here.
Oh, no.
What? Are you okay?
You pesky little pepper.
Are you okay?
No, I'm allergic to peppers. I get severe hot face.
Nelson, es-tu malade?
Oui, un petit peu.
Tu es chaud. Pauvre bébé. Viens avec moi.
Check this out, check this out. I got running the ultimate humiliation. I'm serious, just look.
Here it is. Here it is.
Bam.
Look at that.
All she's doing is brushing her teeth.
No, but no, look at the technique. You see that? She's doing that upward thing. You're not supposed to be doing that. You're supposed to be doing the little circles.
Oh,
I got it. I got it. I got it.
You got nothing.
You're right. I got nothing. She's as clean as a Dutch whistle. I'm toast!
Do you see what I see, man?
What?
Do you see that?
Dude, you don't have a chance with her.
No, no, no. Dude.
Hey, isn't that Ren's boyfriend?
Yeah, but that's not Ren.
Hmm.
Oh, wow. Oh, wow. We gotta film this. There we go.
Yeah, you're getting that, right?
It's jackpot. This is so good, it's scary.
Oh là là. Donny, va me chercher une serviette mouillée.
She said bring me a cool washcloth and some milk and cookies and step on it.
No, Nelson, you're looking much better right now.
Allez, allez.
Sandrine, tu très gentille.
Oh, tu es mon petit chou délicat.
What should I do with the milk and cookies?
Oh, those are for you. You can take them outside to the yard. Sandrine, est-ce que tu savais que je suis de Sakituli?
Non, c'est vrai?
Oui.
I'm going to humiliate Louis by showing his actual bedsheet.
This stain right here is a mixture of pasta, pork gravy, and cat hair. And we don't have a cat, so you guys just do the math. Now, this mystery stain over here has actually started to grow spores. Yes, tiny fungus. We're waiting for the lab results.
Oh, well, you're out of time. Ren, nice work.
Thank you.
I mean, you cut him to shreds and then you stomped on it.
All right.
Lou. Lewinsky. You must be totally humiliated.
Was it? No, I'm okay. I'm okay.
Well, you're gonna have your opportunity to put your sister, Ren Stevens, on the throne of shame when we return after these low-budget local messages. All right, kids, take a break. Dude, you're looking a little wobbly there.
Yeah, well, at least I'm still standing. Can't wait till I get her on the throne. Give me the tape.
Yeah, dude, after you show that tape of Bobby and Mandy, your skanky sheet is gonna be smelling like a rose and she'll be crying like a baby, bro. Yeah! Go get him, man. Go get him. And we are back. This time, Ren Stevens is on the throne of shame. So, Ren, I'm guessing if you win here today, you're not gonna be taking your brother to Happy Mountain with you.
No. I'm not. I'm actually taking someone really special.
Oh, now who would this special someone be?
Well, my boyfriend, Bobby.
Boyfriend?
Uh-huh.
Okay.
Can I say hi?
Give a shout out.
Hi, Bobby. I just wanted to say hi, and I'm really happy we're together, and I just hope we can stay together for a really long time.
Okay. That was so precious. Louis, you're up. This is your opportunity to humiliate your sister.
Yeah.
Well?
Well, Ren is... Ren, well, the truth is, sir, I didn't come to bed.
That is so typical.
Well, I mean, I did catch her brushing her teeth inefficiently, but I taped over that.
Well, my little friend, I'm sorry, but, that does nothing to help your case, or our ratings for that presentation. So, I am forced to declare Ren Stevens the winner!
Hey, what you doing?
Oh, hey, man. I'm just thinking. Finger cheese?
No, thanks.
No? How's it feel to be a big winner?
All right, I guess.
Yeah.
What's the deal with the show? It was like you didn't even try to humiliate me. Not that you even could, but...
Ren? Here. Where is it? Here. I think there's something you should see.
What's this? Not so good. It's, over.
No.
Yeah?
No, Ren, I'm sorry. You okay?
Yeah, I'll be fine.
All right.
Look, I want to thank you for not showing the tape on TV.
Oh, no, Ren, you're my sister. I wouldn't do you like that.
I know, but still.
Yeah.
Thanks.
Mm-hmm. So, Ren, I mean, would this be a bad time to ask you about taking me to Happy Mountain?
Yeah, this would be a bad time.
It would. What was I thinking? Sorry. Ren, when do you think you'll know?
I don't know.
You don't? Not even a guess?
No.
No. Hmm. Right, of course. Ren, listen, I'm trying to be sensitive, okay? But how long will whatever you're going through take to end, Ren?
I don't know, Lewis. Try when I'm feeling a little better.
I didn't mean it like that. I don't want you to be mad at me or anything.
All right, practice standing sit-ups is what I'm doing. Listen.
Cool. I still got it.
She's been around the world and battled countless villains, but nothing could prepare her for this drama. Watch Disney's Kim Possible movie, So the Drama, tomorrow at 8, 7 Central, right here on Disney Channel.
The party just started, so come on in. The good times are all just about to begin. Stand
some fun. We've got a room here for everyone. Gang's all here and we're hanging out. All this fun makes you jump and shout. Hey, little girl, I wanna dance with you. We'll find so many things to do. So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're having a ball
at the House of Mouse.
And now, here he is, that way rockin' rodent, Mickey Mouse!
Hey there, everybody! Welcome to the House of
Mouse. Today, we've got it together, baby.
Horace, Mickey's voice!
Oops, I'm in trouble.
Before we
get started, there's a spinning teacup illegally parked. License plate, are you dizzy?
Wait, that's mine!
Hello, welcome to my club.
Hey, what are you doing here? Making sure you got a show going on, Quacky, because if you don't, I'm shutting you down.
Oh, yeah?
It's in your lease. Says so right here.
Sorry, Pete. You're not on the reservation list. Can't let you in.
Says so right here. Now scram!
Well, we'll see about that. Need to borrow this, Mr. Hood. I'll see myself in, doozy.
See if I ask you to sign my autograph book.
Tonight we got some super great cartoons and Eeyore's 100-acre jokes. But first, the Splashing Pumpkins.
Electric Bill, Phone Bill, Steamboat Bill.
Minnie, what happened? I never knew Donald could fly.
It was Pete making trouble.
Pete? Not again. And are those more bills? I thought we just paid them.
Now, Mickey, do you need a timeout in your wheel?
No.
Good. Now just remember, as long as you keep the show going, the bills will get paid and there's nothing Pete can do.
We'll see about that, won't we?
Excuse me, did anyone order a blue butt baboon? Cause I ain't eating it.
Ow! Listen up, everybody. Donald wants to show a cartoon where he gets the best of Pete.
This is gonna be good.
Gentlemen, gentlemen, it's your boss speaking. If you're not too busy, could you possibly help a customer today?
Sure, if we're not too busy later, maybe.
Oh, good.
Because I've had it with you lazy suckers! So listen up! Whichever one of you makes the next sale gets to keep his job! The other one will be fired! Got it! Now get to work!
Hello? Can somebody help me?
A customer?
Oh boy! Good luck, pal!
Same to you, pal! Howdy, ma'am. May I help you?
I'm looking for an instrument that plays romantic music.
Well, you're in luck, lady, because there ain't no more romantical music than what you can play on this here piano. Romantical, ain't it? So, you want to charge it or put it on your credit card?
That was okay, I guess, but not really what I consider romantic music.
Allow me.
Oh.
That was not romantic music. I'm talking about sitting on the beach at sunset, kissy-kissy sort of romantic music.
So what do you think romantic music is?
Yeah! Well, you know, something like la 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 la. Pop goes the weasel. Isn't that romantic? Well, isn't it?
Yeah, sure.
Uh-huh. Real romantic, old lady.
Well, then, is one of you going to sell me an instrument that can play Pop Goes the Weasel or not? Again!
I was playing her song.
No, I was.
Boys, whoever plays my song best gets the sale.
That's gonna be me, lady. Hey. Well, how was that?
Great! It's just, neither one of you ever finished my song. Oh, that was beautiful. I'll buy it, unless you have something better.
Do I?
Romantic thing I've ever heard. I'll take him.
So long, pal.
Well, well, well. I guess you get to keep your job.
That's right.
So I'll take this and your entire salary for the next year to pay for the damages to my store.
Whoa.
Now clean this place up.
Try it one more time.
Huh? Who let my deadbeat brother in here?
That hurt.
Yeah, but it's a dry hurt.
Now it's time for today's special guest. That donkey with the removable tail, Eeyore!
I just want to start off by saying I'm not going to tell any poo jokes.
But poo's funny.
The other day, Christopher Robin had a birthday party. They played Pin the Tail on the me.
Thanks a bunch.
Lights out, House of Mouse.
Huh? Hey, what are you doing? Stop! Your hands are cold! No!
So I said, one heffalump or two.
The power!
It wasn't me.
How's about a little test, Tootsie?
Donald!
Minnie, the power's out. It's because we didn't pay the bills. Now everyone will panic. What are we going to do?
Mickey, get a grip. I have a flashlight.
You've always got the answers. Oh, my gosh, look!
The battery!
It's dead.
Hey, the show's not over. Wait!
Aladdin, put back that bread.
Mickey, everyone's leaving.
What are we gonna do?
Oh, this is Pete's doing.
He assaulted our battery.
Well, if he thinks that'll stop the show, he's wrong.
But what'd you plug that into? The House of Mouse is back! Now, check out this cartoon where I get to knock Pete's lights out. It's Mickey time.
Help! Somebody help!
Hang on, pal!
Thanks, buddy. Mighty hospitable of you, trusting a stranger and all.
Aw, who'd pretend to be stranded in a snowstorm?
I would! And you fell for it! Right, cousin?
Right, cousin? It's just like old times.
Let me go!
Hiya, pal. I'm Mickey Mouse. I trust anybody, and now I'm tied to a chair. Gee, that's not very swell.
I'll show those two.
I'm telling ya. Robbing money machines is easy, I'm telling ya.
And this here out-of-my-way cabin makes the perfect hideout.
Yeah, but how you gonna get the cash out of the machine?
Huh? Who you calling?
A friend of mine. Police?
You have reached the police. We can't come to the phone right now.
Well, your pal Police ain't home. It's a recording. And just in case you get any ideas about calling the cops, I'm tearing up the C page in a phone book so you can't look up the number. Take care of the dough. You go see what Mouse Boy here has to eat. And don't you be trying anything screwball-y, because I'm clever, see?
Oh, I'll say. And you had a pretty clever plan there. That is, till you made that mistake.
Mistake?
Why, leaving your cousin all alone in the kitchen with your food. He could poison it. And, well, with you out of the way, he'd be rich.
That low-down food poisonator.
I reckon Cousin Pete's gonna cook.
Wonder why he wants to cook so bad. Oh, I know. Maybe he'll poison the food and take all the money.
Just like old times.
Go ahead, cousin.
You first, cousin.
Why me first? Food still poisoned from when you cooked it?
Gosh, I'm sure glad you're not gonna make me test the food. Keep it coming, boy. Oh, yeah, this is poison. It's definitely poisoned, all right.
So you were trying to poison me, eh?
You were trying to poison me, eh?
Say, could one of you two get me some ketchup?
Cousin, I'm hungry.
We're all hungry.
Oh, I'm not. I'm stuffed.
Then stuff it. We ain't slept in 2 days, and I want to get some shut-eye.
Good idea. Of course, it'd be a shame if someone, maybe even someone you trust, tried to steal your money while you were sleeping. Once upon a time, in a cabin in the snow, two cousins who didn't trust each other were trying to steal the bag of money sitting on the floor in front of me. So, neither one of them went to sleep because neither one of them could be trusted. The end.
No way I'm falling asleep.
You saying I'd steal the money?
I'm saying I'll make sure you don't. Just like old times.
Aw, look, fellas, don't start fighting again. And whatever you do, don't use a skillet and a baseball bat.
The only way we're gonna settle this is if we divide it up now and here.
How do I know you won't cheat me just like old times?
Because I ain't a cheater like you, you cheater.
Who you calling cheater, you cheating jader?
You cheat.
I'm not a cheater.
You cheater. No, you are. I'm glad it's not up to me, non-cheating Mickey Mouse, to count that money. Zeke, one for Pete. 1, 2 for Pete, 2 for Zeke. 1, 2, 3 for Zeke, 2 plus 2 minus 1 for Pete. 5 plus 1 for Zeke, multiply 3 and 2 for Pete, add 3 plus 3 for Zeke.
Hey, Zeke's getting more, just like old times.
I am not.
Hey, fellas, I've got an idea. Now that the storm has passed, you could take the money back to the bank and let the teller count it.
Wait a minute. Don't banks charge for counting money and whatnot?
That's what I heard.
You're trying to fool us. They'll take part of our moolah.
Okay. I know another place we can take it, where the money will be counted fair and square.
Oh, lease. Something about this don't seem right, pal.
Wait a second. I know what he's up to. He's taking us to his friend he was trying to call earlier. That police fella is gonna help us count our money, right?
Yeah. Right! Come on!
Look! This place is swarmed with cops.
What do we do, cousin? What do we do?
I'd better hide you. Quick, in here. Here, put these on so the cops don't recognize you. My pal, police, will be right with you.
Hey, cousin. I think Mickey's pal is a cop.
And I think we're in jail.
This is all your fault.
No, this is all your fault.
Just like old times.
We'll be right back with Disney's House of Mouse here on Disney Channel.
Next Friday.
I'm a working girl now, okay?
Well, Raven's big brain.
I'm a designer.
Give her a big head.
I would like my design shipped to Rome.
And I'd like your butt out of my chair.
Catching all new That's So Raven. Next Friday at 7:30, 6:30 Central on Disney Channel. DisneyChannel.com. Play games. Vote in polls. Take quizzes. And email your favorite stars. It's all there, only at DisneyChannel.com.
It's Mike's Super Short Show, where we show you what's new on Disney DVD.
Hey, everybody. We have a great show for all you dog lovers out there.
That's right. We're talking about the all-new, two-disc, 50th Anniversary Edition DVD, Lady and the Tramp.
This is living!
This classic Disney movie is...
And now back to Disney's House of Mouse, here on Disney Channel.
Thanks for the power, Big Z. I'll get you some pocket pitas on the house.
Mickey, you the mouse. I'll show them who's the mouse.
Whoa! Stop! Your hands are cold!
Your pita, sir. And, I hate to tell you this, but the Titans have stolen your chariot.
What? My new Stratus streamer? I'll banish him for good this time.
Oh, sir, your lightning bolt.
Give it up for the splashing pumpkins. Oh, zippity-doo-dah.
Well, this is a fun predicament.
I give up. We'll never keep this show going.
If he gives up, I give up.
Bad news. We just got another pile of bills. Why are you in your underwear?
More bills? Oh, we'll just charge them. Charge them? That's it! Everybody, come with me.
Huh?
One, two, three!
What do you think you're doing?
Mr. Battery, you've been charged.
What?
Nobody stole my chariot, but I see someone pilfering my Peters.
They're still warm.
Good thinking, as usual, Minnie.
Well, the show must go on.
What a great show, huh? Except for the power going out twice.
Hey! Lighten up!
You lighten up.
And now this important word. Are you sad, miserable, depressed?
You better believe it.
Then you need this.
New Disney's Magic in a bottle. Yes, just one spray. And you'll be the happiest person on Earth.
Who wants to be happy?
And for those really stubborn grumps, there's extra strength Disney magic in a bottle. Disney's Magic in a Bottle does not work on Disney villains or lawyers.
That's it for today. See y'all real soon.
Man, I love hanging out at the House of Mouse. It's the only place where all the Disney heroes and villains get together under one roof. And sometimes the results can get pretty wild. Pete's always out to steal Mickey's thunder. Goofy's always goofing up somebody's order. And you never know who the special guest might be. Well, stick around, because there's more House of Mouse next. Right here on Toon Disney. At the House of Mouse.